Calling all units, calling all units. Donut Shop has a fresh dozen. Go ahead and take a 1040.
I want to get into the myth. The myth around police officers liking donuts.
That's true. As an intro episode, we might as well discuss exactly why police and donuts are synonymous together.
Can you give me this napkin?
You're all about napkins.
Yeah, but it's for the sweat.
Oh, okay.
Your side might be 60 degrees, but it's about 92 degrees on this side for some reason. Good Lord.
But yeah, so police and donuts are synonymous. All the way to the Simpsons episodes. Yeah. There's even been movies. I think it's Wreck-It Ralph, and in Wreck-It Ralph, the police officers are donuts in Wreck-It Ralph.
Let's talk about some personal experience, okay?
Okay.
Every time I walk into a donut shop and I'm in uniform, I always feel feel some way, you know? Like, yeah. I'm a little embarrassed.
Right.
And I'm feeding into the stereotype. But who doesn't like donuts is what I'm trying to say.
I have to agree with you. I'm a dessert guy myself. It's usually what dinner is based around, making sure that I can fit dessert in at the end of it.
So, but I don't know. It was such a bad, like, it has this negative stigma around it.
It does.
Police officer. Oh, yeah, cop, huh? So you like donuts?
You want a whole dozen of them? Huh?
Yeah. I bet you like donuts.
Yeah.
Huh? Is that a good one?
Yeah. Huh? Bad cop, no donuts.
No. We've heard that joke thousands of times. Hey, cop, you like donuts? Yeah, dude, you like donuts? Now you like donuts. You're the cop.
Yeah. Hey, cop.
Yeah, no, but definitely the stigma around donuts. Now, I went and did some research. I know you did too, because I talked to you. Back World War I days, okay, there wasn't many, and this is true nowadays, okay? There wasn't many stores or restaurants open late night.
Yeah.
All right. Am I right?
And overnight.
Correct me if I'm wrong.
You're
at
not
any
wrong,
point.
Sir.
Okay.
Not wrong.
Late at night, not a lot of stuff open. So if you're a midnight officer, which is graveyard shift, we call them midnights. What are you on, midnights? Yeah, I'm on midnights. I bet you like donuts. Yeah, that's usually what they say. So you're midnight officers or graveyard shift.
I'm going to partake ahead, while you talk.
Sink into that Bastion cream. So midnight officers didn't have too many options when it came to eating on the job.
Right.
Or as I like calling it, OTJ on the job. So they would go to donut shops because that's really the only thing that was open late at night, around the clock, late at night, were donut shops. So they would go in, grab a cup of coffee.
That usually, similar to now, serve some version of coffee or a caffeinated beverage to keep you awake, because sometimes it's tough to stay awake.
Exactly. So now you have cops in there at night. They're going in, they're grabbing donuts. They're going in, they're drinking their coffee. So it starts, anyone who is not a police officer and you come in late at night to a donut shop, you see usually a uniform officer in there, and you're like, ah, man, these cops really like donuts.
Right.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so they start telling their friends, hey, did you know cops like don't, well, they, this is back in the day, wah. You know, the coppers, they like donuts.
Yeah, exactly.
So they say that to their friends. Their friends tell their friends, because there's no social media, so they didn't post it.
Yeah.
They would just
word on the street was the original social media.
They would
media.
Call them up on the telly, you know, and they wind the, hey, did you hear that? They like donuts. So then they would tell their friend that, and then here comes the rumor that police officers, they love donuts. When in fact, the only thing that was open back in the day, late at night, and true to today, are these donut shops. You have anything to add to that? Because I have more.
Yeah, grab a donut.
I will.
Start to do that. Yeah, donut shops and maybe a deli. Mm-hmm. So you've got your delis in the big cities and then your donut shops that may be open. Or donut shops are also baking throughout the night.
Mm-hmm.
So it's also a form of security where you've got a police officer there to kind of watch over things while they're on their beat, doing their patrols, stop in, catch a cup of coffee, and maybe a donut. The other thing about law enforcement is that when you're eating, you never know when that next call is going to come in. You could be busy on the radio or let dispatch know that you're going to be on a meal, but you're usually subject to call still. So a donut, usually something fast, packed with sugar, so you've got the energy, and so you can always grab it and go rather than, you know, a nice turkey sandwich or a healthy salad or something like that. So, you know, and back then they didn't think as much about their health and what specific, you know, food, like,
healthy.
You know, like the keto guys and stuff.
Yeah, healthy. Come on. Things are healthy. What are you talking about? Listen, to add to that, to go back, because I did my research. The founder, the owner and founder of Dunkin' Donuts. Mm-hmm. I don't know if his name is Dunkin'. I don't know, but I was reading. Mr. Dunkin'. Okay, the guy who created Dunkin' Donuts. He said that he kept his prices low so that police officers come in. They kept it open at night, and they would offer this stuff to the police officers and take care of the police officers. Exactly what you said, to keep security in there at night, because if you want to rob a store, the best time to do it would be at nighttime.
Yeah, less people on the street.
Yeah, less people on the street, concealed from by the night. Mm-hmm. So people will go out, and that's why a lot of these, I wouldn't know because I don't accept free things on duty. However, it is against the rules. A lot of these gas stations offer free coffee to officers that come in. I don't know any officers that take it. Put it out there.
Correct.
But a lot of these late night shops that offer discounts to officers, and that's just to have them around so these robbers don't come in and rob the store. Police presence.
Do a stick up.
Yes, yeah, it's the cheapest way to get security.
Yeah.
Hey, cop, you want to come to my place? I got donuts. Huh?
And then you think about it, a place like where we are in South Florida, hot 24 hours a day.
Yeah, especially on this side of the studio.
Of the table. So hot 24 hours. I'll speak quickly so it'll be over soon.
Yeah.
So, you know, 24 hours a day. So even at night when you're walking a beat and you're not in a car, or if you're in a car, sometimes you got to get out and stretch your legs. You don't have a Walmart to go walk around and stuff back then.
Yeah.
So you get out, you go take a seat, walk around, stand up. Some of these places had bars, kind of like a bar that you could sit at and maybe have a meal. You'd get up and you'd stretch the legs, do some paperwork under a different type of light that maybe they didn't have in their cars. Or like I said, if you're walking around in the beat on your feet, sweating outside, get inside, catch that AC,
boom,
and that good temperature. So
there you go. So this is the story behind the cops and donuts, the whole the association between cops and donuts. There is the history behind that. So it started back, well, I read World War One. Apparently, somewhere in there it said 1940s, 1950s. This is why we need you as the gopher to have the laptop open to be like, aha, no, it was this.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's the stigma behind police and donuts. What's up, Nod Squad? Hope you enjoyed that clip from the Donut Shop Podcast. You can head on over to the Donut Shop Podcast YouTube channel where we have the entire interview. While you're there, make sure to click subscribe and hit that little notification bell so you can know when we upload. There's going to be tons of new content, a whole bunch of guests. If you guys have any suggestions, head on over and hit us up in the comments. All right. Thanks for watching. I'll see you when I see you. And if I don't see you, I'll see you over on the Donut Shop Podcast channel.